Dollar. Dollar, often represented by the dollar sign dollar, is the name of more than 20 currencies, including those of Australia, Canada, Hong Kong, Jamaica, Liberia, Namibia, New Zealand, Singapore, Taiwan, and the United States, whose U.S. dollar is also the official currency of Caribbean Netherlands, East Timor, Ecuador, El Salvador, Federated States of Micronesia, Marshall Islands, Palau, Panama, and Zimbabwe. $1 is generally divided into 100 cents. On January 15, 1520, the Kingdom of Bohemia began minting coins from silver mined locally in Joachimsthal and marked on reverse with the Bohemian lion. The coins were called Joachimsthaler, which became shortened in common usage to thaler or thaler. The German name Joachimsthal literally means Joachim's Valley or Joachimsthal. This name found its way into other languages: Czech and Slovenian thaler, Hungarian thaler, Danish and Norwegian rigs, thaler, Swedish riks, thaler, Icelandic daler, Dutch rauks, dalder or thaler, Ethiopian talari, Italian taliero, Greek tau lambda lambda eta rho omicron nu, tau lambda iota rho omicron, taleron, talero, Polish talar, Persian dare, as well as, via Dutch, into English as dollar. A later Dutch coin also depicting a lion was called the Leeuwendaler or Leeuwendalder, literally lion the lair. The Dutch Republic produced these coins to accommodate its booming international trade. The Leeuwendaler circulated throughout the Middle East and was imitated in several German and Italian cities. This coin was also popular in the Dutch East Indies and in the Dutch New Netherland colony, New York. It was in circulation throughout the 13 colonias during the 17th and early 18th centuries and was popularly known as lion, or lion, dollar. The currencies of Romania and Bulgaria are, to this day, lion, leu, leave. The modern American English pronunciation of dollar is still remarkably close to the 17th century Dutch pronunciation of dollar. Some well-worn examples circulating in the colonies were known as dog dollars. Spanish pesos, having the same weight and shape, came to be known as Spanish dollars. By the mid-18th century, the lion dollar had been replaced by Spanish dollar, the famous pieces of eight, which were distributed widely in the Spanish colonies in the New World and in the Philippines. The sign is first attested in business correspondence in the 1770s as a scribal abbreviation P, referring to the Spanish American peso, that is, the Spanish dollar as it was known in British North America. These late 18th and early 19th century manuscripts show that the S gradually came to be written over the P, developing a close equivalent to the dollar mark, and this new symbol was retained to refer to the American dollar as well, once this currency was adopted in 1785 by the United States. By the time of the American Revolution, Spanish dollars gained significance because they backed paper money authorized by the individual colonies in the Continental Congress. Common in the 13 colonies, Spanish dollars were even legal tender in one colony, Virginia. On April 2, 1792, U.S. Secretary of the Treasury Alexander Hamilton reported to Congress the precise amount of silver found in Spanish dollar coins in common use in the states. As a result, the United States dollar was defined as a unit of pure silver weighing 371 4/16 grains, 24.057 grams, or 416 grains of standard silver being defined as 1,485 parts fine silver to 179 parts alloy. It was specified that the money of account of the United States should be expressed in those same dollars or parts thereof. Additionally, all lesser denomination coins were defined as percentages of the dollar coin, such that a half dollar was to contain half as much silver as a dollar, quarter dollars would contain one-fourth as much, and so on. In an act passed in January 1837, the dollar's alloy, amount of non-silver metal present, was set at 15%. Subsequent coins would contain the same amount of pure silver as previously, but were reduced in overall weight, to 412.25 grains. On February 21, 1853, the quantity of silver in the lesser coins was reduced, with the effect that their denominations no longer represented their silver content relative to dollar coins. Various acts have subsequently been passed affecting the amount and type of metal in U.S. coins, so that today there is no legal definition of the term dollar to be found in U.S. statute. Currently, the closest thing to a definition is found in United States Code Title 31, Section 5116, Paragraph B, Subsection 2. The Secretary, of the Treasury, shall sell silver under conditions the Secretary considers appropriate for at least $1.29292922 a fine troy ounce. However, the dollar's constitutional meaning has remained unchanged through the years. See United States Constitution. Silver was mostly removed from U.S. coinage by 1965 and the dollar became a free-floating fiat currency without a commodity backing defined in terms of real gold or silver. The U.S. Mint continues to make silver $1 denomination coins, but these are not intended for general circulation. The quantity of silver chosen in 1792 to correspond to $1, namely, 371.25 grains of pure silver, is very close to the geometric mean of 1 troy pound and 1 penny weight. In what follows, dollar will be used as a unit of mass. A troy pound being 5,760 grains and a penny weight being 240 times smaller, or 24 grains, the geometric mean is, to the nearest hundredth, 371.81 grains. This means that the ratio of a pound to a dollar, 15.52, roughly equals the ratio of a dollar to a penny weight, 15.47. These ratios are also very close to the ratio of a gram to a grain, 15.43. Finally, in the United States, the ratio of the value of gold to the value of silver in the period from 1792 to 1873 averaged to about 15.5, being 15 from 1792 to 1834 and around 16 from 1834 to 1873. This is also nearly the value of the gold-to-silver ratio determined by Isaac Newton in 1717. That these three ratios are all approximately equal has some interesting consequences. Let the gold-to-silver ratio be exactly 15.5. Then a penny weight of gold, that is 24 grains of gold, is nearly equal in value to a dollar of silver. 1 DWT of gold equals $1.002 of silver. Second, a dollar of gold is nearly equal in value to a pound of silver. $1 of gold equals 5,754 and 3/8 grains of silver equals 0.999 pounds of silver. Third, the number of grains in a dollar, 371.25, roughly equals the number of grams in a troy pound, 373.24. The actual process of defining the U.S. silver dollar had nothing to do with any geometric mean. The U.S. government simply sampled all Spanish mil dollars in circulation in 1792 and arrived at the average weight in common use. And this was 371.25 grains of fine silver. There are many quotes in the plays of William Shakespeare referring to dollars as money. Coins known as thistle dollars were in use in Scotland during the 16th and 17th centuries, and use of the English word, and perhaps even the use of the coin, may have begun at the University of St. Andrews. This might be supported by a reference to the sum of $10,000 in Macbeth, Act 1, Scene 2, an anachronism because the real Macbeth, upon whom the play was based, lived in the 11th century. In 1804, a British 5-shilling piece, or crown, was sometimes called dollar. It was an overstruck Spanish 8-real coin, the famous piece of 8, the original of which was known as a Spanish dollar. Large numbers of these 8-real coins were captured during the Napoleonic Wars, hence their reuse by the Bank of England. They remained in use until 1811. During World War II, when the U.S. dollar was, approximately, valued at 5 shillings, the half-crown, 260, acquired the nickname half-dollar in the U.K. Chinese demand for silver in the 19th and early 20th centuries led several countries, notably the United Kingdom, United States, and Japan, to mint trade dollars, which were often of slightly different weights from comparable domestic coinage. Silver dollars reaching China, whether Spanish, trade, or other, were often stamped with Chinese characters known as chop marks, which indicated that that particular coin had been assayed by a well-known merchant and deemed genuine. Prior to 1873, the silver dollar circulated in many parts of the world, with a value in relation to the British gold sovereign of roughly $1 equals 4s 2d, 21p approx. As a result of the decision of the German Empire to stop minting silver thaler coins in 1871, in the wake of the Franco-Prussian War, the worldwide price of silver began to fall. This resulted in the U.S. Coinage Act, 1873. Which put the United States onto a de facto gold standard. Canada and Newfoundland were already on the gold standard, and the result was that the value of the dollar in North America increased in relation to silver dollars being used elsewhere, particularly Latin America and the Far East. By 1900, value of silver dollars had fallen to 50% of gold dollars. Following the abandonment of the gold standard by Canada in 1931, the Canadian dollar began to drift away from parity with the US dollar. It returned to parity a few times, but since the end of the Bretton Woods system of fixed exchange rates that was agreed to in 1944, the Canadian dollar has been floating against the US dollar. The silver dollars of Latin America and Southeast Asia began to diverge from each other as well during the course of the 20th century. The Straits dollar adopted a gold exchange standard in 1906 after it had been forced to rise in value against other silver dollars in the region. Hence, by 1935, when China and Hong Kong came off the silver standard, the Straits dollar was worth 2.4d, 11.5p approx, sterling, whereas the Hong Kong dollar was worth only 1.3d sterling, 6p approx. The term dollar has also been adopted by other countries for currencies which do not share a common history with other dollars. Many of these currencies adopted the name after moving from a pound SD base to a decimalized monetary system. Examples include the Australian dollar, the New Zealand dollar, the Jamaican dollar, the Cayman Islands dollar, the Fiji dollar, the Namibian dollar, the Rhodesian dollar, the Zimbabwe dollar, and the Solomon Islands dollar. Thanks for watching. Don't forget like the video and don't forget to subscribe.